Hello viewer, my name is Amos Kibrotich from the Corner Brook School. I am a form 3 student. Welcome to Science Up. I will be taking you through quadratic expression and equation 2. So, in form 2, topic 15, we learn how to factorize an equation. And now, for example, when you are given x squared plus 6x plus 9, and you are told to factorize, you first check for the number. When you multiply, you get 9, and when you sum up, you get 6. Those are 3, 3. You take these 3 and 3 and you replace with 6x. So x squared plus 3x plus 3x plus 9. So you take the common. So x into x plus 3 into positive 3 into x plus 3. So this is the same as x plus 3 into x plus 3. In that way, you have factorized this one. Example 2. When you are given x squared x minus 8x plus 16, you again look for the product which is 16 and the sum which is negative 8. You look for two possible numbers. When you multiply, you get 16, and you sum, you get negative 8. Those are negative 4, negative 4. So you replace 8x with negative 4, negative 4, which is the same as x squared minus 4x minus 4x plus 16. This is the same as x into x minus 4 into minus 4 into x minus 4, which is the same as x minus 4 into x minus 4. So in that way, you have factorized x minus x 8x plus 8x. So in form 3, we are going to learn how to complete a square. In completing square, you realize that in this equation, you have factorized this one, x minus 8, x plus 16, into x minus 4, x minus 4. You realize that the x, 8 minus x, 8x plus 16 have factorized into two equal parts, which is x minus 4, x minus 4, which can be written as x minus 4 squared. So this and in a part expression, an expression which factorized into two equal parts is known as a perfect square. So we are going to learn how to make it to make an expression a perfect square. For example, so you will realize that this expression can be written as 4x squared. So in this expression, you realize that A x squared minus 8x plus 16. So A, B, and C. You realize that B over 2 squared is equal to 4 is equal to C. So B squared over 2 is equal to over 4 is equal to C. So if you are given x squared plus 10 x, and you are told to make it a perfect square. You say p over 2 square is equals to c. So p is 10, so 10 over 2 square is equals to c. So 100 over 2 over 4 is equals to c. So 25 is equals to c. So you realize that to make this a perfect square, you add 25. So x squared plus 10x plus 25. In that way, you have made it a perfect square. Alternatively, when you are given x square plus then x, then you are told to make a perfect square. You will add here c, so that you get x square plus 10x plus c. Then you equate x square, and then you put any number which you may put it as k. So you realize that you put this square. X square plus 10x plus c is equals to x square plus 2kx plus k square. So you equate this one, because this one is a, b, c. This one is a, b, and c. So 2k is equals to 10, so 2 over 2. K is equals to 5. But you want c, and then c you will equate this one, k square. So c is equals to k square. But k is equals to 5. So c is equals to 25. That way you have made it a perfect square. You just add here 25. That is completing square. Example 2. When you are given x square and then that is 6. Then you are told to make it a perfect square. So you will come to that expression. So x over 2, p over 2 square is equals to c. And then you have c, which is p over 2 square is equals to that 6. So p over 2 square is equals to that 6. So square this one, square. So p over 2 is equals to square root of that 6. So p over 2 is equals to positive or negative 6. P is equals to positive or negative 12. So there you have made it a perfect square. Alternatively, x square minus plus that 6. You equate x square plus, so x plus k, and then you square. So you will equate this one to x minus, this one is p, plus that 6 is equal to x squared plus 2kx plus k squared. So you will equate this one. You have k squared, because this one is a, b, and then c, and then a, B, so you equate C with C. So K square is equal to that 6. So K is equal to square root of that 6. K is equal to positive or negative 6. But P is equal to 2kx. So 2k is equal to P. But you have k which is 6. Positive or negative 6. So k times negative or positive 6 is equal to P. So P is equal to positive or negative 12. There you have made this one a perfect square. After learning how to make a number a perfect square, we will learn how to solve an equation using a completing square method. For example, if you have given x square plus 4x plus 20 is equal to 0, and then you have told to make to solve. So x square plus 4x plus is equal to 20. We take 20 to the other side. So x square plus 4x plus 4 over 2 square is equal to 20 plus 4 over 2 square. X square plus 4 over 2 square is equal to 20 plus 4 over 2 square. So x minus plus 4 over 2 square is equal to 20 plus 2 square, which is x minus 4 minus 2. X minus 2 is equal to square root of 20 plus 4. X minus 2 is equal to square root of 24. So x minus 2 is equal to positive or negative 4.89. So x is equal to positive or negative 4.89 plus 2. So x is equal to 6.89. So x plus 2 is equal to 20 plus 4. So x plus 2 is equal to square root of 24. So x is equal to 4.89 minus, this is positive or negative, 4.89 minus 2. So x is equal to 2.4.89 or negative 6.89. So there you have solved that quadratic equation.
I have come to the end of our discussion on Science Up. My name is Amos Kiprotich. Keep it a little TV where you watch and learn.